If you're torn between an S6 Edge and an iPhone 6s Plus, worry no longer because this is the Samsung Galaxy S6 Edge Plus, and it aims to bridge the gap between these two worlds. Unsurprisingly, at a distance, you'd be forgiven for mistaking this for the classic S6 Edge. Everything from its hardware controls and capacitive keys to the camera placement are exactly the same. All Samsung's done by scaling the design up is create one of the best looking phablets ever. Despite its broader proportions and a narrow metal frame, it's easy enough to hold. The ergonomics perhaps aren't as fist-friendly as the curved back of the Note 5, but provided you're comfortable with the smooth, reflective Gorilla Glass backing, it's wholly manageable and still impeccably thin at just 6.9mm. The base of the frame features a single mil speaker grille, a headphone jack, and a micro USB port, but Samsung hasn't yet transitioned to the world of USB Type-C, so your current needs and chargers should still play ball. Whilst the Note line has progressively increased in size over the generations, as with last year's Note 4, Samsung's phablets have plateaued at 5.7 inches. Naturally, this particular device comes sporting a curved version of the Super AMOLED Quad HD panel we've seen before, and it's truly beautiful. It may technically sport a lower pixel density than the standard S6 twins, but it's just as stunning. Individual pixels are of course imperceptible, and maximum brightness appears strong too. Colours, in true Samsung fashion, may well be a tad exaggerated, but if it's a phone with impact you're after, the viewing experience on the Samsung Galaxy S6 Edge Plus is a sight to behold, even if those curved edges do distort imagery just a little bit. On the surface, the S6 Edge Plus uses a scaled-up version of Samsung's skin take on Android 5.1 Lollipop, but there are a handful of notable differences. The Edge screen still supports handy features like InfoStream and People Edge, letting you swipe from the side to pull in your 5 favourite contacts, but with an additional swipe you'll encounter Apps Edge, a system-wide app shortcut list that's always accessible. As with People Edge, tapping the plus sign lets you attach any application to this view mode, and for the time being, it's a feature that'll be exclusive to the Edge Plus. Knowing where to swipe takes a little getting used to, and it can be a bit of a stretch, but it's a simple, convenient evolution that gives greater purpose to the Edge screen. In addition, the ability to float or run two apps side by side is a great strength on the phone's larger panel too. The brains of the operation is the same Exynos 7420 octa-core chip that the S6 and S6 Edge enjoy, and the RAM has been bumped from 3GB to 4GB. For a pair of phones that flew to begin with, the S6 Edge Plus is no different, easily offering the slickest performance for a device of its class, and going toe-to-toe with Apple's new iPhone 6s Plus and its swanky new A9 chipset. On the storage side, out the gate there are 32 and 64GB storage options that should suffice for most users, but no microSD expandability will be a bit of a letdown for some. To help partially alleviate this issue, Microsoft's thrown in an extra 100GB of cloud storage from its OneDrive service, and Samsung's managed to wrangle 6 months of free Google Play Music too. Charging is a big feather in the cap of the Edge Plus as well, with Sammy offering official figures of around 120 minutes for a full charge. That makes it 33% faster than the original S6. It also supports faster wireless charging too, meaning you can juice it up in more ways than pretty much any other smartphone out there. The most noticeable crack in the S6 Edge's armor is its 3000 mAh battery. We were expecting around 2 days of use per charge, but thanks to the phone's standout display, we were only managing around 3.5 hours of screen on time, or about a day of general usage. 2 days might be possible with the use of the phone's battery extending functionality, but that will definitely require more delicate handling. Imaging-wise, the hardware inside the Edge Plus remains unchanged from the S6 and the S6 Edge. A 16-megapixel rear camera and a 5-megapixel front facer, but the party pieces fall to the software side this time. In the mode selection menu, you'll find two new features, the ability to live broadcast to select contacts via YouTube and the video collage feature. Just as with the standard S6 twins, camera quality is impressive across both photos and video. You can expect crispy 16 megapixel stills in most conditions, impressive macro performance and attractive, albeit softened, low light results. The wide angle front and rear lenses do distort imagery when you crop in a bit, but the overall results are still pretty phenomenal, provided you're happy with the aggressive post-processing, color boosting, and heavy sharpening the phone employs. Video looks great too, with plenty of resolution options to shoot in, including 4K and 60 frames per second full HD. Image stabilization, autofocus, and auto exposure are all also responsive and effective without being too aggressive. We're intrigued by how the S6 Edge Plus will be received in the market with its killer camera, impressive screen, and premium design. It's unquestionably a flagship device at £599, but with popularity of phones like the Note 4 and the iPhone 6s Plus, there's little doubt that this will sell. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions about the Samsung Galaxy S6 Edge Plus or any of the latest smartphones, just drop us a line down below in the comment section, and you can find out more on recombri.com/mobile. Thanks for watching.